तुम्हारे लिए अब तुम बड़ी जो हो गई हो।
रिश्तों को लगे हीरे की उम्र, पीसी ज्वेलर, ज्वेलर फॉर जनरेशंस।
Wireless drives India forward with Mr. Leaders share their thoughts on the next generation wireless technologies.
My vision is that the maximum data will flow through the fiber optic network.
Qualcomm presents Next Generation Wireless 2011 in association with CNBC TV18 and E18 event. Presented by Qualcomm, knowledge partner and Nisus Mason. Paid sponsors, Huawei, Nokia Siemens Networks, TechConnect, ZTE Telecom. Media partners, My Mobile, Telecom Watch, HT Wind. At these times on CNBC TV18.
Welcome back. The whole edifice of Emami has been built on traditional Indian values, but keeping the customer's interest in mind. Little wonder Emami has become a household name. Like every person, this company seems to have an X factor. To precisely understand what that X factor is, I caught up with 66-year-old Radhesham Agarwal at his upscale residence in Kolkata.
Mr. Agarwal, Sandeep, welcome to the show.
Thank you.
Mr. Agarwal, we begin by asking you, it is normal to see most business family split when it comes to second generation. It is rather amicable or bitter. In your case, how two friends have stayed together and also brought their sons into the business, and not only brought them into the business, but also see that they have got the same kind of passion the way you have built the empire. So what keeps Goenkas and Agarwals together?
We and Goenka are not friends, not brothers. We are two in one. Our soul is also one, and you can see two only as a body. Since our school days we are together, so it's long now, more than 50 years we are together. We know each other's strength, we know each other's weaknesses, and we try to complement each other and supplement each other. In Hindi there is a word, matbhed ho sakta hai, manbhed nahi ho sakta.
That's very well put.
So difference of opinion may be there, but difference of heart is not there. So we discuss, we sort out and everything. And same way the children who have been groomed by us, both of us, they are so well blended with each other. So that difference is not even in the young generation. And we have a governance rule made on the subject, where we say sambandh. रिलेशंस को हिंदी में मतलब होता है संबंध। संबंध का मतलब सम मतलब बराबर, बंध मतलब बंधना। बराबर भाव में बंध के रहने का मतलब ही संबंध है।
So basically, you and Mr. Goenka put all kinds of effort to see both the families are together.
Yeah.
I also believe that you are also working on the succession plan. You have got a 10-member search panel set up. What is the search panel doing today?
Yeah.
What is the mandate?
The mandate is, we believe, we have told them, that it's not necessary that only the best person should be the chairman. Because in a family, now best is a matter of judgment.
Yeah.
One is competence, one should be human relation, one should be sweet, one should be responsible, one should be able to keep money well. So they all will try to, we have given a criterion, that these criterions I want you to judge properly. So we are trying to do it in a manner where they all can coexist. They will evaluate each person on various parameters which have been given to them.
Okay.
That's not their job to suggest that he is the person or he is the person. Then we will do ourselves.
Another unusual thing I've been noticing, you have a 50-page code of ethics.
Hmm.
You're very well defined that Emami will not enter alcohol business, will not enter non-veg food business or tobacco. That means out of the hotel industry. At the same time, you also say that your sons or daughters will not dabble in stock market or will not set up their own business. Why have you hardcoded all this code of ethics?
I'm telling you, these are a very flexible mandates. They are recommendatory, they are not obligatory. Because if you make this as a law, anybody can break it. So we have recommended and trying to bring a culture. But suppose you start a hotel, there must be very strong reason. And you put before the committee, and the committee will decide. Whatever is bad, and which every government knows, is bad for health, for cancer and all. We would not do that business.
So basically, what you're saying is you will not make money at any cost.
We want to make money,
but not at the cost of health.
Huh.
Coming back to the company's operation, how has life changed for Emami after you acquired Zandu Pharma?
Zandu is a big name. Since 100 years or 110 years, we have acquired that. We try to keep tradition of each brand, their brand property, their brand essence, and then we try to blend it with Emami's essence.
So what you're saying, you're not changing your DNA, but you're changing the DNA of Zandu Pharma.
We don't change the DNA of Zandu brand. We try to blend both of them together in a manner that before nobody sees, before anybody sees that they have changed, the change comes automatically and naturally to them.
Okay, in the scheme of things, which is better way to build business? Buy or build?
Both. Because it's very difficult to define buy of what size.
Okay.
Buy maybe, sometimes people are buying companies which are beyond their sizes and financial resources. So we are already keeping in mind that no purchase should be made which is much higher than our worth, and we must not go for those purchases where our debt becomes very much. We would not like to buy on borrowed fund.
Okay, let me get Sandeep here. Sandeep, you heard Mr. Agarwal talking about strategies, how he built his business. What is the sense you get of this company? What is the reason they have been successful?
If you look back, it's obviously got a long history. It's been around for 35 years. What we like about the company is that it's been built over time in a very focused manner. So it's been built in a way brick by brick, and what they've really focused a lot on is building the brands. Yeah. Clearly the product quality has been there, and they stuck to a particular kind of product, you know, within the healthcare. It's about, you know, using natural resources. Plus, they worked very well to build a very strong distribution network. Now, given the size of the country, the two elements are very important, and brand and distribution, because they've got some great brands in the portfolio. Plus, with a distribution reach which goes out to 500,000 retailers, what they've ensured is that they set very high barriers of entry for competition to come in. And this is in fact probably what Mr. Agarwal calls their assets, which allows them to acquire brands, and they can apply similar principles to the brands they acquire now.
Okay, Mr. Agarwal. The other thing I want to ask you is, will you always bet on Ayurveda, or you also look at alternative medicines like homeopathy or Unani to have more product from that category?
Emami has made a brand portfolio, Ayurvedic, natural, chemical also, because there are certain days, science space we call them.
Okay.
And for every range, whether oral, whether eyes, whether ears, and whether is, we are not against anything, but we try to analyze the safe chemicals. So this is not Ayurveda or anything, simple thing. In nowadays, what is harmful for his skin in long run.
What's your next big dream?
Sir, I don't have any dreams. I'm telling you frankly. My dream is to ensure that my company run well, my employees do well, my workmen are happy, and whosoever works with Emami, he is very satisfied. He makes profit.
How does HSBC help a company like Emami with your global connections?
See, it ties into the trend. What we've seen is that gone are the days where companies venturing out of India were just the top 2-3 companies. Now what we're seeing is a lot of large mid-sized Indian companies are also venturing out of India because they have the confidence. And I think Emami is a good example where obviously for the, you know, first 20-30 years of its corporate life, it's very much within India. But over the years, it has ventured out into markets such as UAE, Dubai, Egypt, Bangladesh. And the advantage a global bank like HSBC can provide is that clearly we have presence on the ground in these very countries, and we are able to assist our customers like Emami to help them set up base and get them access to finance and help them with the environment. Mm-hmm. Because it is quite a challenge at times when you're venturing into a new market. And the people on the ground and people who are your trusted partners, we are able to assist very strongly with that, and we then link up our coverage in Calcutta going out to the coverage in Dubai, Egypt, Bangladesh, so that works seamlessly for the company.
Okay, Mr. Agarwal, what are the ingredients one needs to succeed in business? Is it luck? Is it money? Is it people? Is it ideas? What according to the success mantra?
I will say it should be blend of everything. Because if you have no money, you cannot do business. If you have no luck, you cannot do business. And ideas, but if ideas you have but you do not have money, so all these are the pillars of success. If one pillar is weak, the building will fall. And one thing I will say is most important is details and honesty.
So what is the advice you give a youngster who wants to start a business? What are the do's and don'ts he should do or should follow?
He should not dream only, and he should see limitations and see his strength and try to utilize his strength. Then wherever he wants to go, he should have a definite purpose. Then he should create a mastermind. Keep those who have faith in that definite purpose, they all join hands together. Like me and Goenkaji have joined. So he should create a field who have faith in that definite field.
Thank you, Mr. Agarwal. Sandeep, for being on the show.
Thank you.
Well, one must say that Agarwal is walking the talk. These are the mantras that help Agarwal build Emami. Embrace the goodness of Indian joint family system. This has worked like magic for Emami. Surround yourself with a team of specialists and empower them. Keep the organization flat and create a homely atmosphere. This will not only attract good talent, but also increase productivity. Profit not at any cost. According to company's code of ethics, selling tobacco, alcohol or non-vegetarian food is a big no. Keep doing SWOT analysis constantly and then leverage on your strength. Finally, believe in the art of giving. This does not relate to charity but means giving due credit or praise to people wherever possible. This will kill ego and boost morale. Well, those are Agarwal's brand of mantras, the kind of mantra they don't teach you at Harvard. Clearly, looking at Emami's story, there's a great merit in the Indian joint family system. On that note, it is time to say goodbye. See you next week with another interesting story. Till then, keep watching CNBC TV 18.
Presented by HSBC Commercial Banking.
Hi babes,
seen him at Jalan?
Hold it with Jellyfin.